In this video, we're going to learn several different ways that you can resize images from within Photoshop. So take this photograph that I've got here. This is a stock photo, so it's quite a large file size. So let's say that I want to make it smaller. I can go up to Image in my top menu and then Image Size. And then if I change the width to 500, which is smaller, and then click OK, you can see it's made it smaller. What it's done is it's kept it still in proportion, so the width and height resized in the same percentage to give me my resized image. I'm just going to undo that resize and go into Image, Image Size again. Now the reason that when I resized it, it kept it all nice and in proportion was because I had this little link button clicked. If I just click that again to turn it off and do exactly the same thing again, change the width to 500 and click OK. Now what this has done is it's changed my width to 500, but it's kept the height the same. So it's squidged my photograph down to 500 without changing the height. And as you can see, this really doesn't look very good. So when you're resizing something, I would always recommend that you keep that little link button ticked so that everything gets resized in proportion. So I'm just going to unsquidge our poor little cat by hitting Ctrl and Z on my keyboard to undo. You can also change the size of the canvas, which is the size of the file you're working on, if you want to make that smaller, but without actually affecting the size of the image. To do this, you go to Image again in the top menu, and then Canvas Size. So again, you've got the relative button. If you tick that, it will change it directly in proportion. But we don't want to do that in this case, because what I'm going to do is turn my rectangle image into a square one. So my height here is 1440. So if I type 1440 into the width and click OK, Photoshop's going to warn me that I'm making my canvas smaller than the size of my photo, so it's going to crop some off. That's fine, so I'm going to hit proceed. And what that's done is it's taken some space off the left and the right side of my picture, so it's now the same width as it is height. So if I undo that to get my original cat back. Now that's all well and good if you just want to resize one single image, but what if you've put it onto another file and you want to resize it from there? Well, I'll show you how to do that as well. I've got this background here that I've already created, and I want to put my cat into the middle of this, this file. So I'm going to go over to the cat. I'm going to hit Ctrl and A on my keyboard to select everything, Ctrl and C to copy. I'm going to click over to my background and hit Ctrl and V to paste. So you can see this has put the cat onto my background, but because my background is quite small and the cat photo is large, I can only see a really tiny bit of the photo, so I need to resize it to make it fit. I'm also just going to rearrange the layers on the right hand side. So you can see my photo here is layer 5. I'm going to click and drag to the top to put it on top of the polka dots. Okay, so to resize the cat photo, first I'm going to zoom out using Ctrl minus on my keyboard. Because the photo is quite large, this is going to make it easier to resize. I'm going to select the Move tool, which is the top tool in your tools palette. And then over at the top, there's a little box which says Show Transform Controls, and I'm going to tick that. This gives me a bounding box around the edge of my photo, so I can click and drag on one of the corners to make my picture smaller. And when I've made it small enough so that it all fits onto my background, I'm just going to zoom in with Ctrl and Plus so I can see what I'm doing a little bit better. So now my picture is nice and small. I'm going to click and drag to center it, so when you get the horizontal and vertical pink lines, you know you've put your thing that you're moving directly in the middle of your design. All I need to do now to complete the resize is hit enter on my keyboard, and now that cat photo has been resized to fit onto the graphic that I'm creating.